Hello and welcome to Drummer's Review. I'm Nolly, and today we're looking at a Pearl Sensitone baritone mahogany snare drum. This drum is a high-end 15-inch by 5-inch deep snare drum, and it's made out of 4 plies of African mahogany, 5 millimeters thick, with maple re-rings. The 15-inch diameter of the snare drum allows you to tune it lower than your average snare drum while still maintaining plenty of head tension. It comes in at £539 RRP, so let's take a closer listen to it in a few different tunings and come back for some more discussion afterwards. Our initial impression of this drum is it's really great looking. That matte finished mahogany looks awesome. And weirdly, even though it is bigger than your average drum, it doesn't immediately look like a particularly large snare. Those arch type lugs also are very striking visually, and Pearl claim allow for a smoother tuning action. We definitely were big fans of how they looked on this particular drum. From factory, this comes with a coated ambassador on the batter side and a clear snare side ambassador on the rezzo side. And it also features 20 strand wires. Sonically, we feel like the 15-inch diameter actually has quite a lot to offer here. In the low range, it carries a body and note where smaller drums would be flapping around, whereas you start to tune up into the medium and high ranges, you get loads of that great pocky, satisfying attack without the note being overly high-pitched. Particularly in the high tuning, we enjoyed that dry sound that you get without the overtones becoming overly prevalent and without the fundamental pitch being too high-pitched. Throughout the tuning range, we really enjoyed the woody character of this drum. It's got a ton of low end, yet at the same time, the rim shots give you quite a lot of attack too. It is worth mentioning that in the low tuning, the playing feel was a little bit sluggish, so we're certainly quite happy that Pearl stuck to a 5-inch depth here, because perhaps anything more would have started to lack articulation. In terms of the styles and situation that this drum might be suitable for, we think it could be particularly good for earthy, rocky alternative sounds. At the same time, it could be a very interesting option for anyone that likes to get creative with their tuning, either as a main snare or as a side snare tuned really low. This drum has certainly opened my eyes to the capability of a 15-inch snare drum. I think any collector would do well to have a drum like this in their collection, just to expand the range of tuning possibilities you've got. This drum is of the very highest build quality. It looks great, feels great, and it tuned up incredibly easily too, which is indicative of a perfectly made shell and bearing edge. The hardware fitted to the shell is all top notch, and we're particular fans of that strainer, which has a very assertive click to it, at the same time quite a short throw that allows you to get it on and off quickly with minimal noise and fuss. Overall, we feel like this drum offers good value for money to drummers out there who want a more interesting, unusual drum, a bit further off the beaten path, and want to get creative with their tuning. It might not be the best option for drummers out there looking for a particularly bright, high-pitched, cutting snare sound, but for those of you who like a good wood snare, it certainly could be a really interesting drum that would find its way into many musical situations and hold its own. To me, the best thing about this drum is it inspires you to get creative and perhaps get you to play some things that you wouldn't ordinarily play. The only real thing that I could say as a negative point would be that slight lack of articulation in the low tuning, but if you're belting out a backbeat, there's absolutely nothing to complain about. And it's certainly still a really cool and usable sound. Let us know what you think too by leaving us a comment. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time at Drummer's Review.